Ventures. This is a course we've been offering at Lisbon MBA for quite some time. We used to offer it in many other different places. It's essentially about startups of many different types, especially technological startups and their financing. Basically, we're looking at different ways to finance high-growth startups or med-tech-ish high-growth startups. We're not going to focus in any particular industry. In reality, probably I think the first case study we're going to look at is a restaurant with big ambitions. But basically, we're going to cover many different industries from biotech to different areas of engineering, software, and internet. We are going to do what I would call a traditional sequence in a course like this. We're going to look at what are entrepreneurial ventures, how do we analyze them as investors, and indeed very frequently we take the perspective of the investor. As I'll try to convince you, is that the most critical thing to survive is being able to raise money. So what do investors want in return for your money, for their investment, sorry? And to make things even more complicated, different investors want different things. So we're going to take for a while the investor's perspective and how they analyze ventures, and then essentially to get how much is a new venture worth. The most stupid answer is net present value of something coming out of a business plan, and to make things really interesting, we are not going to spend much time on business plans. I work in venture capital. We don't spend much time on business plans. We put real money on real businesses. We don't put real money on paper. And you have to convince us that you have a strong case for investment. In order to convince us there is a strong case for investment, you must have a strong value proposition to a very interesting market. That's how we value startups. We are going to look at the simple, what we call, venture capital method to value startups. And we are going to look at a few, probably three, pitches on Shark Tank to discuss what was behind the valuations that were reached there. Then we look at venture capital deals and look at how venture capital works and venture capital deals. And now the thing which scares entrepreneurs, which are the term sheets. And then try to convince you that valuations are not really that important. If a venture capitalist knows what he or she is doing, the valuation doesn't really matter much because we don't engrave the value of startups in stone. What is really relevant is how we split the pie at the end. And the way we split the pie at the end, if you are professional, depends on the size of the pie, not on something which was decided 5 years before on a stupid term sheet. So that's why venture capital deals are so complex, but on the other hand, so interesting. And this is why probably a lot of founders of startups get very scared when they get these 7-page term sheets with things totally incomprehensible for them. We're going to work mostly with case studies. We're going to look at startups who have to make financing decisions and how they're raising funding. Then we are start looking at later stage funding. In one case, when things go so well, what are the dilemmas faced by the founders? In another case, when things are going wrong, what are the alternatives? And then at the end, we are going to look at exits. We are going to use the case study of what is arguably the most successful startup in Portugal in terms of exit. And if things go right, I'll try to have the founder here. Actually, I have been speaking in this room at least 4 times on my venture capital master's course, which I've been offering every year. How do we work with case studies? I mean, I can give you tons in theory and game theory on venture capital investment. I think nothing beats looking at real life situations and how people handle real life situations. So we work with case studies, are going to work with a simulation. We have to simulate the full life of a startup from inception to exit and try to figure out all the dilemmas which are faced. And by the way, in spite of this being a course called financing, a lot of people got very surprised by the fact that not much of it is on traditional finance. There is no Modigliani Miller here. There are no discounted cash flow valuations using complicated Excels. People who are obsessed with Excel are basically telling me they are totally incompetent. Money is not on Excel, money is on selling things to clients. That's where money is, and that's where I want to see the money, not on Excel. So basically, most of your grade is class participation, presenting case studies in class, and a take-home final report on a case study that is given to you 2 days before the exam. I think this is it. Thank you very much.